Hello, and welcome to my show. I am your hostess, Wilma Deckfit. And today we are going to talk about things that plague this world. Now, once upon a time ago, we only had to worry about the Italians, you see, and life wasn't so bad. But the world, you see, it has changed. It has changed, and instead of banding together to make fun of Italians, we just turned on each other somehow. Tragedy, it is. It's tragic is what it is. It's tragic. And I think it's time to open the channels of communication once more, you see. We need to talk, yes? We need to communicate more. Just a little more. So I would like to formally open the gates of tolerance and understanding with this statement. Everybody fucks funny to somebody. Everybody. I myself enjoy it when an elderly Armenian woman tans my ass with the July 17th, 1972 edition of Sports Illustrated magazine while I am juked on by a baby octopus.
If you would like to Google what juking on a baby, that's all you bitches. That's all you.
My point remains the same, you see, that just because you think it's funny doesn't mean they think it's funny. And you need to be tolerant. I, Wilma Deckfit, showed tolerance just the other day. I was at the bank, you see, and it was thrice bells the morning time. An odd time to be at the bank, yes, but a safe time, for you see, the meth heads were they were mowing the intersection. They were occupied. I'm not sure whether the lawnmowers had gas or even existed for that matter, but it kept them occupied, and they're high enough to think I'm actually a woman, so, you know, go meth heads. So I leave the bank, you see, I walk out of the bank at thrice bells morning time, and whilst I am walking home, I am passing by ye old pawn shop. A pawn shop that is never open. Quel bizarre, yes, very. Pizzagate, my friends, Pizzagate. And you think I am in jest, but let me tell you this. As I was walking towards the pawn shop, I happened to see a woman, which is not peculiar. What was peculiar was that this woman was wearing a bath towel, you see. Yes, it was a very fluffy looking one. It would perhaps be but an odd piece of clothing to wear at thrice bells morning time. I don't even know why that's funny. Thrice bell morning time. And I see this woman in a bath, a fluffy bath towel. And I am concerned. I'm very concerned. This is an odd time of day to be in a bath towel. Let alone a bath towel on a sidewalk in front of a pawn shop.
I am walking over towards this woman, bearing in mind I have just left a bank and have a reasonable sum of money on me, as I am walking towards this woman, I say, "My dear child, are you okay?" And at some point, between me saying, "Kay," and her turning around to face me, you see, the towel disappeared. There was no towel. And I'm not sure that it might have been like the lawnmowers, and it was never really there. And this woman, who was no longer wearing a bath towel, says to me with complete and total casual innocence, "I don't know. Do I look okay to you?" Now, I pride myself on the ability to dialogue. Yes, you see, I speak, then you speak, then I speak, then you. This is how the dialogues work. And I pride myself on being able to do a dialogue. It's... So in an attempt to have a dialogue with this woman, the only thing I could think of to say was, "Wow! Those are nicer than mine." And being as that is the only thing I could think of to say, it was the only thing that I did in fact say. And she looked at mine, and she looked at hers, and she looked at mine, and she didn't touch mine. And with her other hand, she did touch hers. And she said, "You know, I think mine are better." And then with the hand that was on my breast, she took my hand and put it on her breast and did ask the question, "What do you think?" To which I, in the most sexually ambiguous voice I could muster, said, It was an interesting moment, you see, and she tousled my hair and this and that, and she says to me, "If you want, for $100 I'll take you up to my room." Now, I am not one who is unfamiliar with this, you see. I have been to hooker hobbies. I understand. I have had women tell me it's $400 for me to lick their shoe. You need to up your standards. So I kindly thanked the woman for her offer, and I removed my hand from upon her breast, and in a last-ditch effort to woo me, I suppose one could say, in an attempt to woo me, she said, "Are you sure? You can use my ass as an end table." And I thought, surely you jest. And then I balanced my purse on her ass, and... So to get to the end of this tale, what should have been a 10-minute walk home took somewhere around 45 minutes, because, you see, I had a large quantity of money on me. And I'm pretty sure this woman knew I had a large quantity of money on me, and I am not a fool, and I knew that there was a man somewhere who was going to take my money. Kind of lost my accent there. So you see, if I am willing to express such embarrassment, such open humiliation,
vision of myself to you. What say you? Share and enjoy.
I'm just a bitch with a cell phone. What the fuck do I know, right?